Okay, so what I'm going to share with you is how to generate quantum results and how we have evolved a methodology. And the intent of it is coming later, but this is a visual of what we are at Anand. Around 14,000 people at 61 locations, including 6 hospitality management locations, luxury resorts, and 19 companies. The Anand products that we deliver to our OEMs in India and overseas are auto component systems for engines, powertrain, climate control, filtration, chassis, and suspension. We do not put together an automobile. We were thrilled to get from the current Prime Minister, Honorable Theresa May, when she was the Secretary for Home, the Golden Peacock Award for Innovation Management at a session, what they called as the London Global Convention for Sustenance. So that's what some of our thoughts got reinforced. So that's, as Mr. Ramesh said, I'm becoming an evangelist, because sustenance requires continuous improvement and innovation together. The journey of manufacturing excellence at Anand started way back in 2007, when around 6 managers were given in sort of Gurukul setting to Professor Shoji Shiba, who is our mentor. And there you see that at the end of 7 years, we have really focused on business, even in lean in manufacturing excellence, and that is on generation of cash flow. We need to pursue profits. We need to focus on the customer, quality, and prompt delivery, and we always think it's a conflict. It isn't. If these two are not there, pursuit or profit and customer focus, you cannot generate cash. So therefore, we need to bring two opposing forces together. That is one of the principles of innovation. You need to come to a crossroad. What have we done in the two journeys, journey of innovation at Anand and the other is the VSME, Visionary Small and Medium Enterprises? In around 5 years' time, we have been able to cull out around 950 people whom we call fire starters, and they are about to become the nucleus of a fission thanks to a diksha given by our late President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He said, you have done great, but now create fission, he says. So we have got that nuclei of almost 950 people to touch at least 50% of 13,000 people we have at Anand. What have these people done? They have worked on over 500 strategy-focused challenges, which bring down into over 1,200 individual challenges, and we have generated over 50 crores of additional money beyond the budget, which was a surprise. So what I'm trying to drive is anything that we do, problem solving, continuous improvement, or innovation, has to generate money. If you cannot generate money, you cannot generate wealth. And this can be done only when you add jobs. So manufacturing is a job creating sector. So we should be very proud of it. I am thrilled to be a part of manufacturing. This is some fact I want to show to you, because everybody believes in facts. If you look at it, 2 large companies of Anand, Gabriel and Spicer over here, typically we were accustomed to around 10-15% as continuous improvement. But when we adopted a systematic out-of-the-box thinking methodology, we have been able to go to improvements not in 1 year, but over a period of 3 years. And if you look at the first case, cost of consumables have come down by 57% they have come down. It's possible, but it's a step-by-step time-consuming journey. And how much have we added? We have added around 6.5 million to 20 million in around 2 years' time from these projects. These are just symbolic marquee projects. What have we done in visionary small and medium enterprises? 2008 was a year of realization for us that at Anand, we have got 19 companies and our typical raw material cost is over 68%, which means manufacturing doesn't happen in Anand. Manufacturing happens at our supply base. And then, thanks to Professor, we said, we need to transform them, not do a supplier development and audit. So an audit was scrapped, a VTF put in place, and we used to visit small people, and I made a commitment at my graduation ceremony that I will spend 60% of my time for my suppliers instead of working on strategy. I did a most, admin most, and I got a shocking realization that I was spending over 70% on solving day-to-day problems in the plant or meeting people, I used to feel good. But the day I realized it and didn't do it, I could do more for my suppliers. And that is how one of my senior colleagues who hold a similar position, he has been able to go to all these 10 locations, and beginning with 23 people in one location, we have touched 500 out of over 1,100 suppliers of ours, and just see what has happened to them. 23 times is the number in which direct supply is taking place to our plants. We saw that in TKML yesterday. They have got 3 levels. So I was very thrilled that we have also done something. We are not a Toyota. We are a much smaller company, only a 8,500 crore company. But I believe that we have got the taste of that, and now we are more energized. 35 to 40 suppliers every year graduate through this workshop. And what is important over here is the journey for them starts in our plant, not in their plant. So we take responsibility of getting our plant transformed by our vendors. And they say, sir, if you are able to spend so much time in your own plant, why can't I, as a CEO of my organization, believe me, there are 2 crores to 200 crores, they go back and start transforming. Otherwise, they are happy to sit in their so-called fancy EC cabins, which I don't think we corporate guys have, and they want to run the business. So that's the transformation. So the journey starts at our place, and then for the next 3 years, we go back to their companies and work for them virtually. Delivery performance. We thought that 100% was a dream. But yes, we have been able to transform delivery, not only from our suppliers to us, but from us to our OEMs. This is very funny. I like this slide. If Anand has grown by 86%, right? This is the Anand sale growth. We are very proud to see that our suppliers have grown a tad over us. And the other thrill that gives us is that their growth has ensured that they rely on Anand for only around 40% of their business, which earlier they relied on 85% of their business. So we are feeling thrilled because we have made them more independent. So the principle over here is transform manufacturing in the plants of supply. Then when you look at these innovation journeys, what we say as concourses, last year, the group of around 180 innovators led by their 20-odd leaders, they presented a check of 5 crore rupees to the bottom line of Gabriel. So if they had a bottom line of around 75, their bottom line swelled. It's all about people. We took on this journey last year to learn from how small people worked. Because Anand Group, at the end of the day, when we say there are 61 locations, we are all small plants, from 50 crores to 250 crores. We have got some of our suppliers who are larger. So I, as a part of ACMA, we took a journey to help them. So I worked with them. I committed 12 days of mine, along with my colleagues who gave 6 days, and we went and helped them with these tools and techniques. At the end of the day, gentlemen, all that I'm trying to say is there has to be discipline, orderliness, and commitment to follow a methodology, not wild creativity. We don't want to be Pablo Picassos. We are not here to make sketches. We are here to imbibe a culture. A culture means system. Whether I do it and X and Y does it, it has to be the same result. And most important, it has to be transferable. So, coming back to productivity, very confusing thing. I have struggled for over 25 years of my 32-year-old career in understanding what it is. And because I was made to speak over here, I think I got some gyan. So thank you, Doshi Sam. So what I say is, if we have to track, if you can't measure, you cannot control, is one of the quality principles. And here what we have to see is there are 3 types of people in an organization. So a productivity measure has to be at their language, not at my language. Who invests? The stakeholder. So if we have to attract them, we have to talk to them only about measures of business results, not my CNC machine is giving 750 pieces instead of 250. You go and tell your CEO, he says, so what? Has it got me better business? If you go to a senior operations leader, you need to talk at his level. at the level of operations using relevant units. For example, number of shock absorbers produced in a plant per person. And then you cannot judge everybody. If Hosur produces X, Devas, which produces railway shock absorbers, cannot be at the same level. So we need to accept it at leadership level. So again, I want to drive, it is leadership's attitude. So one of the statements I have started making is, productivity is attitude. The right measure of productivity is attitude. How do we behave? We typically get lost over here at an operations level. Can anybody tell me what is the tip? When I use the word productivity, can you tell me one measure of it? Commonly used measure? Output per machine hour or output per man hour? Question is, so what? Doesn't help business. It may help that people. But what I'm saying is, we need to measure it at all three levels. Only then we can create music. Otherwise, music will not be created. Otherwise, it will be chaos. So where did it start? So this started sometime in 2009 or 10, where we said we need to evolve a new mindset at leadership level. And this is Professor Shoji Shiba. Big M. We need to go to big M from small m. Small m is production. Big M is everything around it. We talk of CFTs. I don't think CFT is the right word today. It is cross professionals you need. You need an accountant sitting on a idea implementation plan. We need to respect his thought. He also comes up. Normally we say an accountant comes in, he's going to challenge the ROI. No. We have had some accountants jumping into this journey, and some of the ideas they have come up, they are better than an engineer. So this is what we need to understand. It is, we have to move from CFT to CPT, cross-professional teams. So what is Big M? It's a small depiction. Big M is all about being able to survive under global competition. So you need to look at customer. You need to look at business change. It is much more. It is business processes plus environment. So we had a dilemma. And when I started this journey, full-fledged at corporate level in 2010, the first thing that hit me was complaints from all the manufacturing heads of the CEOs. We have too many initiatives, sir, what to do? We can't do systematic thinking. It's a fact. Life is complicated. So what are the initiatives? So then we thought of understanding how to balance. Life is all about balancing. So we have problem solving on one side. We have continuous improvement. Problem solving is quick solution on the in the shop, a small kaizen. Continuous improvement is you take on a challenge to go beyond your current improvement. But there is a quantum leap also required. So let us understand what are the enablers for these. And it was a big surprise that you cannot use the same tool to get the same result. I normally use Marshall Goldsmith's statement, what got you here will not get you there. So if you have been able to solve a problem on a machine, applying the same thing will not create a breakthrough. You have solved the problem for that shift, that month, that's all. So we know all these things. What is required? I got this help from some of our gurus. They talked of breakthrough idea and breakthrough implementation. We need to recognize a mindset. Can a leader or an individual, and here is what we said, everybody has got the same number of gray cells. If you do not use it, they are going to rust. So do you know why you thought of an idea in a certain way? If we can trigger that as leaders, there is going to be a big change. So this is what we have started practicing. And being an engineer, we have written an SOP. Because it has to be communicatable down to the last person. Extremely thrilled to announce that one of the plants in Gabriel, their security and contractual fellows who takes care of housekeeping has also learned this methodology. And he has brought a change. So what's the principle? What's the concept? The concept is Professor Shiba's three-eyed Buddha. You see the breakthrough loop. You see the control loop. And you see the continuous improvement loop. So this is a cycle. So the breakthrough loop rests in our head. It's invisible. And we need to leverage our third eye. And the way we do it is